For a number of years, one of the main responses when we find people that are facing hunger has been to deliver food. Food aid is part of the solution to a hunger-free world, but it's a short-term solution that's inadequate in addressing the causes of hunger. And what we need to do is think about long-term solutions that set people up to be sustainable and to be able to feed themselves going into the future.
In a refugee setting, hunger-free can only be achieved through bringing in food. But in a community setting that practices subsistence farming, it can be achieved through food production for themselves. The starting point is somebody who's food insecure or hungry. We feed them for the short term, but during that time, the time that we're freed, we ask them to invest it in building an asset that we know will actually be useful for tomorrow. In less than 18 months, people have built an asset, and in this particular instance, a fish pond. And at the end of 18 months, they have been able to sell and harvest out of that fish pond, coming from not having enough to eat, and in 18 months, having to actually invest in an asset is amazing for me.
We saw programs that were working really well at eradicating hunger. And so this really inspired us about what would be possible if this could be taken to scale. We go to that community, we invest, we lean in, we commit, but when we leave them in a place in which they are hunger-free, in a place in which they are hunger-proofed, where they are growing enough, they're generating enough to be able to take care of themselves and develop their own community. We believe we can make a difference to end hunger and end the causes of hunger and create a hunger-free generation and a hunger-free world. But we need to start somewhere.